Hi, Micah and Joe. Today, the candidates held their fire, instead focusing on their voters and getting them to the polls. Election Eve in Chicago, a quiet end to a bitter campaign. Both Lori Lightfoot and Tony Preckwinkle opted for small retail stops rather than a big pre-election rally. Early this morning, Lightfoot greeted voters at this Southside L stop.
Good to see you. How you doing?
Later, she crisscrossed the north side.
How are you?
Voting for you.
Oh, I appreciate it. Thanks so much.
Lightfoot ends the campaign leading in the most recent poll, an incredible feat for a first-time candidate facing a seasoned political heavyweight. The most recent poll shows you with a big lead. Are you nervous, anxious?
Well, I just want to make sure that people come out and vote. Never does anybody any good to be overconfident. And we've been touring the city now for the last 3 days, really encouraging people to come out. And I think there's a lot of energy and enthusiasm, but we need to make sure that people turn that into actually going to the polls.
Tony for mayor.
Early afternoon on the west side, prominent Preckwinkle supporters led voters to the polls.
And they're going to vote. And they're going to vote for Tony Preckwinkle. They're going to vote for Tony because they have seen what Tony has been able to do. Not just talk about it.
That a not-so-subtle jab at Lightfoot never holding elected office.
Tony for mayor!
It's one of the many ways Preckwinkle and her allies have tried to paint Lightfoot as a roll of the dice. Can you just take us back to that moment when you realized it was going to be you and Lori Lightfoot? Talk about how difficult this fight has been.
No, this has been a really hard-fought campaign, and you know, I look forward to victory tomorrow. I'm grateful to all the good people who have volunteered in this campaign and the staff that worked so hard.
And so now it's in the hands of the voters who will choose the black woman they want to make history. One candidate will win, the other will lose, but there is talk about unity. Both candidates have agreed to appear with Reverend Jesse Jackson at an event Wednesday morning. We're live tonight in Jefferson Park. Tamon Bradley, WGN News.